It's time to rev up your engines. America's Car Show with Tom Torbjornsson is on the air on WBBZ-TV. Brought to you by the AAA of Western and Central New York. Get the AAA guarantee at all Western New York Car Care Plus locations. By Napa Auto Parts. Get Napa know-how. And by Dunn Tire. Service you deserve from professionals you trust at Dunn Tire. Now, here's Tom Torbjornsson.
So we're back out on location. We're going to test drive a new vehicle that I'm really excited about. And I've got my friend Ron Fryer here from Town Automotive, sales and leasing consultant. Welcome to America's Car Show.
Well, thanks for having me again. I appreciate the time.
You know, you selected a really interesting vehicle for us to take a look at today. It's one of the, it's another compelling vehicle, that being the Santa Fe Sport 2-liter turbo.
Right. Well, we're staying with the same theme here. Totally redesigned vehicle with the Santa Fe, and then also it's a turbocharged motor, which is a new feature with the Santa Fe's. They used to have a 4 and a 6 cylinder option. Now we're offering a turbocharged motor.
I love the way the lines swoop downward.
Absolutely. Again, the fluidic sculpture gives it the presence of motion while even standing still.
Looking at the wheels, we're looking at some nice chrome wheels. Interesting. Actually, they look like they might be able to resist corrosion pretty well too.
It's a great wheel. This is the turbocharged vehicle, as I stated, and so you get a 19-inch alloy wheel with this. If you got the regular 2.4-liter, you'll have a 17-inch wheel.
Okay, so the 19-inch, shorter aspect ratio on the tire, better control of the vehicle, turning, cornering, handling, that sort of thing, wider footprint on the tire.
Absolutely, yeah. That's correct.
Show me this 2-liter power plant with the turbo setup.
Absolutely. It's going to give you roughly 276 horsepower, which will be rate comparable with the V6. So
that's
you're not
more
losing
than
power.
That's more than the 283 Chevrolet V8 in 1963.
There you go.
And it's a four-cylinder. Wow.
Absolutely. So it's a gas direct injection, which is the GDI there. It's a turbo, so it's a 2.0 liter.
Yes.
The great thing about it is with the older Santa Fe's, the V6 was around 270. You get more horsepower out of a four-cylinder and better fuel economy.
Amazing. I want to take a walk around the driver's side here. Look at the mirrors. Am I seeing LED lights on these mirrors?
That's correct, Tom. You get LED turn signals in the premium. It's a leather and premium equipment package.
I see.
And on the front headlights, you also have xenon headlights as well, high intensity discharge, which lasts almost 15. They last about 15 years.
Show me the cargo carrying area.
Absolutely. If you step back here with me. So if you just look in the back seat here, you'll see you have a lot of room. Now the Santa Fe, I want to show you this feature. It's unique to this vehicle. This Santa Fe, when you get the leather package here, this vehicle will actually recline forward and backwards.
Okay.
That's actually going to come down forward and backwards. So if you're on a long trip, you can recline and kind of rest in the back. Not only that, but the seat actually goes forward and backwards.
Oh, nice.
Which is a really unique feature in a sport utility vehicle.
I would have to say that. I've never seen a back seat that moved.
Now, the seats here are 40-20-40. That's a new feature as well. What that means is this seat is 40%. It folds down if you'd like it to. The middle folds down. It's 20%.
Show me that. I really think that's cool.
So there's a small handle here on the back, and you just fold it forward, and then that way you can put this down. Basically, the functionality with that, Tom, is if you want to have an adult in the back on both sides, and you can still have your skis or your snowboard or your ladder in the middle there.
Super. Let's go around and open the trunk area.
Absolutely.
Actually, it's not a trunk. It's a hatch.
That is correct. So you open your hatch here and you have a lot of functionality. You actually get more space than the 2012s.
Mm.
You have some cargo space in here if you want to put a few things down there. There's storage under here as well. And then also, it's a great feature. It's not on all the new Santa Fe's, but when you get the leather package, you have a handle right here, which makes it very easy to fold your seats down. Takes out the cumbersomeness of walking around to the front again and in the back when you're loading your cargo.
Yeah. All right, you know what's next.
The test drive, I hope.
Yeah, we got to drive.
I get really excited for these.
Yeah, indeed. Let's do it.
Yeah. Okay, so we're driving this really nice little Santa Fe. Is this a 2013 or 2012?
It's a 2013 Santa Fe, wow. All new redesigned, new motors. Okay. It's a completely redesigned Santa Fe.
Yeah, comfortable.
Very nice. You get new seating surfaces, you got upgraded audio. Top to bottom, this is a brand new vehicle.
I like the engine. It's got a lot of torque. I'll tell you, these little four cylinders are amazing. Every time I get behind a wheel of one, it just blows me away. Look at this. Wham! It's just like a hot rod.
That's 276 horsepower, Tom, putting to the wheels there.
Let's drop the gears and get a little revs going here.
You're getting 269 foot-pound of torque at 6,000 RPMs.
Brakes feel really nice. We're talking four-wheel disc ABS?
Four-wheel disc, anti-lock brakes. That's absolutely correct. This will give you electronic stability control, adaptive brake force distribution. It's fully loaded as far as safety and convenience goes.
That I like. The brake force distribution system is an awesome system. Talk about that.
Basically, in any type of emergency situation, you press the brake pedal at an accelerated rate, meaning that you're slamming down on it in speed. Right. There's a sensor in there that can actually tell how fast you're pressing the brake pedal and understands that you need to apply more pressure to the tires and brake force. Right. So it'll actually assist you in that as opposed to a normal braking situation. So it's like an extra emergency precaution available on the vehicle. And that's completely involuntary. It just does it on its own.
Now, what I like about that, too, because when you have a system like that working in concert with ABS and traction control, now you've got a vehicle that's going to give you a stable, controlled stop.
Right. The vehicle is also extremely safe. It comes with 8 standard airbags. Most SUVs don't come with that many. You get 2 in the front there, your front driver's side. Then you have 2 in the A pillars, 2 in the B pillars, and there's actually side curtain airbags back here for your rear seat passengers.
Nice. Talk to me about the price of this vehicle and the gas mileage run.
So there's a couple different price points, Tom. It depends what motor you're looking for. So let me just give you a quick preface. This Santa Fe only is available in a 4-cylinder now, and you can get a 2.4-liter normally aspirated motor. And then you can get what we're driving today, which is the 2.0-liter turbocharged. Mm-hmm. You're at about 200 horsepower on the 2.4, and you're at about 270 with the turbo. Price difference will vary. You're going to save about $2,000 with a non-turbo motor. So let's just use the vehicle we're in right now, for example. This has a sticker of, I believe, $33,000, and this is the leather premium package.
Okay.
Okay, so $33,000 MSRP, that's a turbocharged motor, leather, heated seats, rear view backup camera, and a lot of nice features. You can go up a package, and then you're going to be around the $35,000 range. You can also go down and get out of the leather and the heated seats if you like. Gas mileage, on the turbocharged motor here, you're looking at around 24, 25 on the highway and about a 21 average on normal day-to-day driving.
I always tell people, I've told my listeners, I've told my viewers over the years, if you have a choice of getting a regularly aspirated motor as opposed to a turbo, or a larger engine, always go with the larger engine because ultimately it has to work less when you step on a gas. So you're not putting as much gas in the engine. If you get the less powered engine, unless you're very conservative, you're gonna find yourself having to push more on a gas pedal to get the vehicle to work for you.
Well, I got to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, this was a very, very impressive and compelling test drive in this Hyundai Santa Fe Turbo. Ron Fryer, Town Automotive, thanks so much for the opportunity for America's Car Show to come in with a camera and just take a look at this marvelous vehicle.
Well, thanks for giving Town the opportunity to show you the new Santa Fe and asking us a few questions. We appreciate your time as well.
You know, I know you guys got a website. I'm not sure if I know the correct spelling of the organization. So why don't you give them the website so they can go online and see these vehicles?
Absolutely. You can find us on townauto.com, and that's TOWNEauto.com. And that'll have a full list of our new and used inventory as well.
Thanks, Ron. Greatly appreciate it.
Well,
once again.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Pleasure.
Yep.
On location at Town Automotive, Orchard Park, I'm Tom Torbjornsson. This is America's Car Show.